I'm Dr. Aletha McIntyre. I'm a scientist here at Science North. I'm going to use this model to demonstrate the phases of the moon, eclipses, and seasons for you. If the Earth were the size of this quarter, the moon would be the size of this dime, and they would be a meter apart. So, my moon is way too small, and I'm going to hold it way too close to Earth. Same for the sun, but it works. My moon is light on one side and dark on the other side. Now, half of the moon is always lit by the sun, but it isn't always the same half. The moon spins on its axis, just like the Earth does. As it orbits around the Earth, it spins just once on its axis. So we always see the same face of the moon. So when the moon is aligned with the sun and the Earth, it's a new moon. This new moon rises and sets with the sun. So it's in the daytime sky, but we don't see it because all of the sunlight it's reflecting is directed away from the Earth. As the moon continues in its orbit around the Earth, it begins to wax. From Earth, we begin to see a crescent of the lit side of the moon, and the moon is visible at some times during the day. A quarter of the way through its orbit, we see a half moon, which we call the first quarter. Halfway through the orbit, we see a full moon. The moon then begins to wane. Three quarters of the way through the orbit, we're back to a half moon. We call this the third quarter. The moon then returns to the new moon position. So how come we don't have a solar eclipse every new moon and a lunar eclipse every full moon? Well, that's because the orbit of the moon is inclined to the plane that the Earth orbits around the sun, which we call the ecliptic. So every time the moon orbits around the Earth, it crosses the ecliptic twice. But we only get an eclipse if the moon happens to be crossing the ecliptic during the new moon or coming up and crossing it during a full moon. Now, the moon takes 29.5 days to orbit the Earth, which is about a month. And in fact, months are based on the moon cycle. So how come our calendar months aren't in sync with the phases of the moon? Well, that's because it takes 11 days longer for the Earth to orbit around the sun as it takes for the moon to orbit around the Earth 12 times. So in order for our calendar months, our 12 calendar months, to synchronize with the seasons, we've added extra days to the moon cycles. So what causes the seasons? Well, that's the tilt of the Earth's axis. So you can see the Earth has an axis of spin that's tilted about 23 degrees from that plane of the ecliptic that we talked about. So when the Earth is like this and the northern hemisphere is tilted directly towards the sun, let me move this over so we can go all the way around our sun. We in the northern hemisphere are experiencing summer. And actually in June, we experience the summer solstice, which is the longest day of the year and the shortest night, and we get the most direct sunlight. 3 months later, in September, the Earth isn't tilted towards or away from the sun, and we experience the fall equinox, which has equal day and night, about. 6 months later, during December, we experience the winter solstice. So here, we have the longest night of the year and the shortest day of the year, and we get the least direct sunlight. 9 months later, it's March, and we experience the spring equinox. After 12 months, the cycle of the seasons is complete. So I remember how to move this model around by using the right-hand rule. So if I think of the North Pole of the Earth as up and I stick my thumb in that direction, the direction my fingers curl is the direction that the moon spins on its axis, that the moon orbits around the Earth, that the Earth spins on its axis, and the direction it orbits around the sun. I hope that helps.